It looks to be the beginning of a lovely day, Holmes. There's nothing like beginning the week with a sunny Monday, with nothing more pressing to do than to see what came in the post. Would you care to take a ride up the Thames today?
I think not, Watson.
Listen, Holmes, your mood has been getting progressively worse for the past 2 weeks. I know you, and I am certain that something is bothering you. It wouldn't be bad news from Switzerland, would it?
We would already be on a boat heading towards the continent, were that the case, my dear Watson.
Very well, then, what is it? Let me guess. For the past 2 weeks, the papers have talked of nothing other than this French thief, Arsène Lupin. He's been making all of the police officers on the continent look like complete idiots. You're taking an obvious pleasure out of reading these articles.
My dear Watson.
I've put my finger on it, haven't I? I know you well. Something tells me that you will not entertain talk of this Lupin for some time. Do you recall his to rob her of a priceless set of diamond jewelry that once belonged to the Medicis? These jewels were to be part of the lady's dowry on the occasion of her marriage to the son of a wealthy, influential Sicilian. Finally, our friend, having committed his crime, left word for the local press explaining that there was no other way for the charming lass to escape a marriage of convenience with, I quote, an uncultivated and uncouth boor without the least refinement. Since then, the lady has been confined to a convent, and rumour has it that the two outraged fathers offered a sum of countless millions of liras for the head, the rest of the body being optional, of the man who is responsible for their dishonour. Are you acquainted with the reputation of the Italian criminal milieu? Why, another letter from the zoo about those missing birds, as if we were going to be running around the whole of London chasing chickens. As I was saying, are you acquainted with the reputation of the Italian criminal milieu? This Arsène Lupin must be in hiding somewhere, surrounded by bottle treasures. How foolhardy and arrogant. Oh, these French. However, he didn't pursue this foolishness to the point of risking stepping onto British soil.
Has the cat got your tongue, Watson? What? Whatever is the matter with you, Watson? Pray tell.
This letter on the table. Holmes, read it.
Thank you.
Holmes, this is truly unbelievable. Surely this cannot be taken seriously.
It's possible, Watson, that this letter is nothing but a prank. However, a small chance exists that both the challenge and the threat are real.
What will you do?
First, I'm going to enjoy the breakfast Mrs. Hudson has prepared, if you would be so good, Watson, as to clarify some of the riddles in the letter. Firstly, if Arsène Lupin is actually the author, as he states, why does he sign with another name? When it comes to the poem, even if an answer seems straightforward, we must be quite certain. What would the target of tonight's theft be if this letter turns out to be accurate? We have one day to find the solution and to take preventative measures. You could go see Barnes, the bookstore in Glentworth Street. Surely they'll have something that will be informative.
Holmes's violin. The Reichenbach Falls. What an awful memory. It's the steel harpoon that pierced Black Peter, master of the sea unicorn. Terrible memories. Ooh, the adventure of the dancing men, I recall. Thank you. It's a coal bucket in which Holmes stores his cigars. What a strange idea. This is how Holmes organizes his correspondence that is awaiting responses. If only his clients saw that. My eccentric companion keeps his shag tobacco in the toe of this Persian slipper. Colonel Gordon, it was during the affair of the lodger in treatment. What? This accursed statue is still here? I have asked Mrs. Hudson to remove it for us. Holmes's table for experiments. A motley collection. Treaty on Cornish, the Celtic language of the Cornish people. And here, medieval pottery. Holmes has an interesting taste in reading. It was in this statue that we found the famous black pearl of the Borgias. Oh, what a mess!
I am not ready yet, Watson.
No, I have nothing to ask him. I have no interest in going there. No, I have nothing to ask him.
Sir? Sir?
I have no interest in going there. Poor Barnes should hire a cleaning lady. Oh, what a mess!
Gnithruth, Kudwilm, Lizrit, Sublilil.
Good day, Barnes.
Ha, 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 How are you? I didn't hear you enter.
Are you busy? Am I disturbing you?
Not at all. I was researching, but if you came to see me, it must be that you're looking for something specific. Perhaps I can help you?
A very strange affair, bewildering even, has brought me to see you. An affair involving a Spanish cape and a one-eyed, one-armed man.
Most certainly. You will find the works dealing with naval history on one of the shelves somewhere.
Thank you. I'll go look. Ah, here's my book, The Great English Sailors. As it happens, I found this book and...
Excuse me, my dear Dr. Watson, but I am in need of tranquility.
Well, farewell, Barnes.
Now tell me, Watson, what progress have you made? Have you found the meaning of the mysterious signature?
It's an anagram, Holmes. The letters in Arsino Lotino can be used to spell out Horatio Nelson.
That's a welcome confirmation. No doubt the target for the theft is somehow connected with the Battle of Trafalgar, won by Admiral Lord Nelson at the expense of the French. Nelson, who lost an eye and an arm in battle, has a statue high atop a column in Trafalgar Square. It says that the object of the theft is sitting at his master's feet. There's nothing to steal on this column. We have a map of London here somewhere. Let's see if we can find a site of interest near Trafalgar Square. Have you found the map of London, Watson? Thank you.
Holmes's sidearm. Holmes's makeup and accessories. With the help of this, his disguises are very impressive. Holmes's makeup and accessories. A scandal in Bohemia. Holmes's very first adventure. But why is he keeping this journal? Holmes is not the type to archive his past adventures. A scandal in Bohemia.
Oh, the photo of Irene Adler. I'm not surprised that Holmes kept it. To him, she is the only woman. He perceives her as being so superior to the rest of her sex that he can't even speak her name. Could he have felt something close to love for her? Who knows?
Ah, Holmes's Order of the Legion of Honor. I wonder why he doesn't display it on the wall. Hinayana, the oldest Buddhist school, Ceylon. Holmes has some strange bedside reading. To think that this statue saved Holmes's life during the adventure of the empty house. Let's leave this young man to his strange reading. Treaty on Cornet. It at last, the map of London.
So, according to you, what is there to steal in Trafalgar Square? Show me on the map, Watson.
The only location visible is the National Gallery of Painting, which faces the column.
Why not? Our man wants to steal a painting, but which one? Watson, shall we head out? Let's take a tour of the National Gallery. While you find us a hansom, I'll send a message to Lestrade to have him join us.
No, I have nothing to ask him. Ah, Lamb, good timing. Can you give myself and my friend Sherlock a lift?
With pleasure, Dr. Watson. The mistress, Miss Bromsby, gave me the day off. I'll wait for you.
So, Holmes, what are we doing? What do you think, Holmes?
Good afternoon, gentlemen, and welcome to the National Gallery of Painting. As it's such a lovely day outside, you're the only visitors at the moment, and likely will be for the whole day, as the minimum number of people for a guided tour is...
We're not here to visit the museum, young man. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is my friend and colleague, Dr. Watson.
Sherlock Holmes? The famous detective?
Indeed. I have reason to believe that a theft is being planned that will take place here, perhaps as early as today.
A robbery?
I'm not certain, but there is a good reason to believe that is the case. We have contacted Inspector Lestrade at Scotland Yard, and he should be joining us momentarily. Meanwhile, rest assured that we are here in an official capacity. In the meantime, you can certainly help us. One of the paintings will play a part in the matter, but I don't yet know exactly which one. I do, however, have a few clues that should tell something to a specialist like yourself.
Ah, yes, of course. As it happens, I've only been working here for 3 days. Actually, I'm an apprentice, and my duties here are essentially administrative.
Thank you. pray tell, would I be correct in deducing that the elder of the two men that we can see up there is the director of the museum?
Yes, that is Sir Pointer. He could certainly assist you better than I, but at the moment he's terribly occupied and will be for some time.
But the location that you are proposing is unworthy of my work. All of my pieces are hymns to color and light. It's the very stars, the sun that you want to extinguish.
Please understand, dear sir, the entrance hall is reserved for temporary exhibitions. We are able to add more lighting.
In that case, you would have to provide lanterns across the whole length of the ceiling and to use the most refined oil possible. Definitely not gas. And mirrors to reflect the light, along with some canvases in basic colors to bring out the contrasts.
We will do all that we possibly can.
Nevertheless, I insist that a number of my works must be on the main floor next to the large pieces.
But our rooms are already full and, as you know, each has its specific subject. Too much modernism?
How can there be too much modernism? Modernism doesn't exist. Only art exists. Art is timeless. Art is cosmic.
Well, sir, perhaps we should continue this conversation in my office.
Then you must certainly have a letter of the works that are shown in the museum, with a description of each painting.
Yes, Sir Pointer entrusted it to my care this morning, so I could familiarize myself with the collection, but I lost it. I know, I make a rather feeble archivist, but while I was doing a tour of the museum, the painting that Mr. Pointer is now dealing with arrived, along with cases full of canvases that he had to quickly inventory.
The case of the missing ledger. What do you make of it, Watson? Listen, Mr...
Palliner, sir.
Palliner, my friend and I will make our way through the museum in order to find the ledger. If you lost it while touring the museum and it wasn't back on the desk, then it must be in one of the galleries. Stay here and we'll return to see you when we have found it, and not a word of it to the director.
Certainly, sir. With many thanks, I will continue to do my inventory and await you.
Tell me, young man, would you happen to have a blueprint of the building in order to facilitate the task at hand?
Ah, yes, yes. Where did I put it? Oh, yes, here it is.
Farewell, Palinor.
What a mess! Oh, what a mess!
A lovely painting by Murillo. Impressive. La Tela Real by the great Spanish master Diego Velazquez, 1599 to 1660, painted from the golden century of Spain. It depicts a royal boar hunt. The Adoration of the Name of Jesus, El Greco, 1541 to 1614, Spanish painter from Crete, belonging to the Mannerist school. The Lamentation of the Dead Christ by Giuseppe de Ribera, a Tenebrist painter. This canvas by Tiziano Vecellio, better known as Titian, is an allegory of prudence. It reads, "From the past, the man of the present acts an apostle, Giuseppe de Ribera, 1591 to 1652.
The Toilet of Venus by Diego Velázquez, who was considered, along with Francisco Goya and El Greco, as one of the greatest artists in all of Spanish history. A Peasant Boy Leaning on a Sill by Bartolomé Esteban Murillo, 1617-1682. Christ Driving the Traders from the Temple, canvassed by the Spanish master El Greco. Christ Healing the Paralytic at the Pool of Bethesda by Murillo, one of the most important figures in Baroque painting in Spain during the 18th century. Jacob with a Flock of Laban by Josep de Ribera, also called Lo Spagnoletto, or the Little Spaniard because of his height. The Vendramin Family, venerating a relic of the True Cross by Titian, a Venetian paper, died in 1576, leader of the 16th century Venetian school of the Cinquecento. A Portrait, Madame Moitessier, by Ingres, who was also a violinist on the side, like myself. French Painters Gallery. Monsieur de Norvins, portrait by Jean-Auguste Dominique Ingres, 1780-1876. The Billet Doux by Françoise Boucher. A Beautiful Landscape by Boucher, Françoise, a master of colour in the Age of Enlightenment. The Battle of Genappe by Horace Vernet, one of the victories of the French Revolution. Horace Vernet, The Battle of the Hanau, which took place in 1813, the beginning of the end for Napoleon despite this victory.
Watson, come quickly.
What is it, Holmes? What have you found?
A painting by my great uncle, Horace Vernet. I had forgotten that his work could be found here. It is certainly this ancestor to whom Lupin made reference in his letter. Such talent, don't you think?
Who?
Also, but in a different field. The Emperor Napoleon I, or Bonaparte as we English prefer, painted by Horace Vernet.
The Scale of Love by Jean-Antoine Watteau. Born in 1684, died in 1721. French painter, one of the first in the Rococo Commedia dell'arte, who loved to depict theatre and festivities in his paintings. Perfect Harmony by Jean-Antoine Watteau. A Canvas by Nicolas Poussin that tells of the discovery of Moses. Very nice. The Adoration of the Golden Calf by Nicolas Poussin, a classical French painter from the 17th century who spent most of his productive career not in Paris, but in Rome, on the fringes of the prominent schools of the era. Jacques Cazot, portrait by Jean-Baptiste Perronneau, born around 1715, died 1783.
There, it seems that there are hundreds of entries. Let's bring it to the archivist.
Portrait of a Woman by Perronneau, French school, pastel on paper. Horace Vernet, my ancestor. Magnificent, this landscape at sunset. A Canvas by Joseph Vernet, my great-great. Triumph of Pan by Nicolas Poussin. The Spanish Painter's Gallery.
Yes, Mr. Holmes?
Farewell, Palinor.
Yes, Mr. Holmes?
Here is your ledger, my friend.
You found it! Many thanks. You won't say anything to Sir Pointer.
Rest assured, are you familiar with how the entries are written? Everything seems to be abbreviated.
I understand how to locate a thematic group and how to read a description, but I am struggling with the location codes.
It's better than nothing at the moment. We're searching for a painting that has a connection to the Battle of Trafalgar.
Depicting what exactly?
According to this poem, it could be...
Thank you.
Lord Heathfield of Gibraltar. The Evening Star by William Turner. Mr. and Mrs. Andrews. John Constable. A Canvas by William Turner. Margate from the Sea. Margate from the Sea by A Magnificent Landscape by Gainsborough. Thomas Gainsborough. The Painter's Daughters Chasing a Sun Rising Through Vapour by William Turner, 40 years before.
Yes, Mr. Holmes?
It might refer to a boat. Its master was Admiral Nelson, and the thief wanted to run it aground. Moreover, the boat would have a French name.
Wait! I have a suggestion, symbolic even. The Fighting Temeraire. A Turner. In this painting, Turner is described as having mastered painting techniques, and it is one of the most beautiful English paintings of all time. The subject, a boat by the French name of Temeraire, was involved in the Battle of Trafalgar.
Did you say?
Yes, Admiral Nelson was on board. Temeraire received a special distinction, but I am not certain of which. The painting shows it being towed to the breaker's yard, I believe.
Where would I find it?
I don't know. You would have to search through the English works of this century near the west section of the gallery.
My thanks, Palinor. Come, Watson, let's take a look at the painting. A River Scene with a Dutch Yacht by van der Capelle. An Architectural Fantasy painted by van der Heyden. Jacob van Roosdael, 1628 or 9 to 1682, one of the major landscape artists of Dutch Golden Age of the 17th century. A Coast Scene, Jan van der Capelle, Amsterdam, 1626 to 1679. Lady Coburn and her three... Queen Charlotte, painted by... Here's what I've been looking for. The Fighting Temeraire. Splendid. What do you think?
I agree, it's splendid. The existence of this painting would seem to give credit to this whole affair.
As long as this painting remains on this wall, this letter, even if it is eloquent and provocative, is nothing more than a letter. It is possible that all of this could be a hoax with no substance whatsoever. We will know soon enough, as the theft will have to take place tonight.
We must warn the museum's director, Holmes.
You are correct, Watson. Shall we?
Fantastic! This collaboration will be my crowning glory, my masterpiece. Merci!
I have finished the inventory of the works of art, Director. Oh, and I have the pleasure of introducing the great detective Sherlock Holmes and his companion, Dr. Watson.
Good day, Gent Gallery. I trust that you are here for pleasure and not business?
I'm afraid that is not the case.
Oh!
When it is no longer a matter of art, the artist must make his excuses. Messieurs, until we meet again, no need to accompany me. I know the way.
My apologies, gentlemen. Have you been waiting long?
Mr. Palinor was able to answer all of our most urgent questions. Tell me, who was that man who just left?
That was Horace Velmont. A French painter. One of the best, seemingly, salons in Paris.
A Frenchman? Let's take a look, Watson.
Yes, he's very avant-garde. He heard that we were showing the works of modern painters during our temporary exhibitions. He has loaned us a number of paintings and has promised to donate those that have the greatest success to the museum.
Lestrade, just in time. And the Frenchman, Watson?
Gone?
Director, this is Inspector Lestrade from Scotland Yard. Lestrade, this is the Director of the National Gallery, Sir Poynter, and his assistant, Mr. Palinor. Lestrade, would you have your constable on duty guard the entrance and make sure that nobody comes into the museum? Director, is there anything else?
No, but...
If you would care to follow me, I'll show you what the motivation behind all of this is. The reason for this little gathering is this letter that I received at my lodgings this morning. Without getting into too much detail, it claims that this painting, The Fighting Temeraire, will be stolen tonight.
Pardon?
There now. It's because of a letter that you've disturbed me. You believe that?
I would never have been completely confirmed was not written by the one and only Arsène Lupin.
Arsène Lupin?
Arsène Lupin?
Us? Arsenal? Who? Lou?
Or not this letter is a fake, or if I had reason to disturb you, Lestrade. But you must understand that we couldn't take even the slightest chance.
Perhaps. Why not simply put this thing under lock and key in the bank or at Scotland Yard?
We cannot risk storing the painting in an improper...
What I propose, Lestrade, is to do a tour of the museum with Sir Poynter in order to check any possible points of break and entry and leave two men on duty here tonight. The public and not let anyone else in.
If you feel it's necessary.
And you, Holmes?
I'll pass by tomorrow at dawn. We'll know then what we're up against. Should the unthinkable have occurred, I insist that nothing is touched until I arrive. Is that clear? Let's be off, Watson.
Listen, Inspector, I have a lot of work to take care of. It would be better if I leave you to do a tour by yourself. You are, after all, a professional. Here are the keys to all of the locked doors. If you need me, I'll be in my office.
Well, I best inspect the museum to find any of Lupin's possible exits, including mice holes. No, no exits on this side, nothing to report. Ha ha! There is a possible entry. If someone wanted to descend from the roof here, he'd need a lot of time, and it wouldn't be a quiet business. But I'd be wise to leave a man on duty here, and he will signal the alarm movement coming from the roof. Arsène Lupin, it's you and I now. No windows, no possible entry. No, no exits on this side, nothing to report. No, no exits on this side, nothing to report. No, no exits on this side. Nothing to report. That chap must have been rip-roaring drunk when he painted that one. It's shocking that certain artists persist in painting with their feet. That chap must have been... When I see this, I tell myself that life isn't fair. We amputate too many soldiers, not enough painters. It's shocking that Anybody who will steal this painting to take it out of the public eye deserves a medal, not the Old Bailey. That chap must... Don't get a headache from thinking too hard. Nothing to report. Nothing to report. We need a cannon to force this door down. The lock is too big to be jimmied. And I'll leave a man on duty in place. If Lupin does come, it won't be that way. Nothing to report. Nothing to report. I will make sure there are no windows, and therefore ways in, here.
Do your work. I will draw a map for you, Inspector.
Wait for tonight. There. The director and his underling have left. Time for us to play now. It could be that this whole robbery is nothing but nonsense. If not, we are prepared. And this Lupin will play right into our hands. I'll lock the main door to the museum, and you will be locked in. Jeffries is on duty in Trafalgar Square, and the yard is nearby. Nothing to worry about there. The doors leading in will be locked, but you will each have everything you need to open them. Stay hidden and cover your light so you cannot be seen from the roof. You, Lockhart, will be stationed near the painting itself. At the least provocation, go down to the entrance and sound the alarm. The walls are too thick, so you will have to go down for your whistle to be heard. In case of real trouble, be sure to fire with deadly accuracy. Because if you even graze one of the paintings, your great-grandchildren will still be paying off your debts. Finally, you'll just have to be content with your lanterns. Gas is too expensive. Wits about you. You'll be relieved at 4 a.m.
Oh.
Go on, you cantankerous codger. You have work to do.
You're right, Holmes. The constable below was indeed asked to deliver us a letter. It's from Lestrade.
Nothing good can come from such urgency.
Indeed, Holmes. This time, without doubt, the painting has disappeared. According to what he's written, they've turned the National Gallery upside down looking for it. Our presence is required immediately.
Well, Watson, the game is
for men from the force to protect the painting.
I think that a whole brigade could not have stopped Lupin. And, of course, we can now be certain that it was he who was behind the theft. First and foremost, the police have a city and lives to protect, and we must respect that. Watson, a hansom will be hard to find at this hour, and Billy, our page, is sick. Would you be so good as to flag one down while I take a moment to reread this letter?
Yesterday, I was a doctor, and now I've become a valet. No, sorry.
Is it Sherlock Holmes who lives in these digs here?
Indeed.
Know him?
I do have that honour. I have been of some assistance to him on occasion. Like locating hansoms, for instance.
I say, you're his valet. So tell me, does your master pay well then?
But
I bet you're not above winning a bob or two, am I right? Listen, my friend, word has it that your boss is going to have a right fright tonight at the picture museum.
How?
Shh, listen, my good man. If you want to fill your pockets, here's my card. Piers Urquhart Allen, that's my name. Independent reporter's the game. And I'll pay you well. Look for me in one of the pubs around here. You can't miss me.
If Holmes finds out that the press is onto this business, he'll be in an explosive mood. Best to avoid speaking about it. Ah, a hansom.
Holmes, we haven't touched anything while we were waiting, except for a ladder, which...
or is Velmont's shoes, and those made by one of the two crooks of Velmont.
What do you want, Miss? The only one who will be happy is Velmont. His painting.
Yeah, he's doubly happy, but he'd never come to show his gratitude in person.
Ah, and when will you be done with your investigation, so that we can put the paintings back in their original places?
A deadline will soon be set, I think. However, it is in our best interest to do it as quickly as possible. Thank you, gentlemen.
Good. We'll be here if you have any further questions.
Mr. Holmes, Inspector Lestrade wanted you to know that we no longer need the ladder. If you want it, it's near the director's office.
There is something here. There is something here. There is something here. This poem by Lupin surely makes reference to four paintings presently hanging in the museum. Shall we begin our search? Canvas by Joseph Vernet, my great, great uncle. Here's what I've been looking for. A winter scene with... Some of his works inspired Baudelaire to write Rembrandt's Sad Hospital Full of Murmurs. A work by David Teniers, the younger. executed in 1629 or 30, illustrating the hopes for peace between England and Spain, the painter's mission at the time. Rubens was, in effect, also a diplomat. Portrait of a Man, canvas loaned to the museum, work of an unknown artist, dating between 1645 and 1655. Here's what I've been looking for. Look, a white horse standing by a sleep by Peter Verbeek, possibly derived from a 1652 print by Paulus Potter. A Family Group by Gonzales Cox. Lady Elizabeth Thimbleby. Here's what I've been looking for. Tobias and the Archangel Raphael by Adam Elsheimer, German painter. The Archangel should ask what kind of bait he used. This canvas was